There are safety officers to ensure health protocols are being followed in workplaces. Now, that assurance coming from Philippine Labor Chief Silvestre Bello III in response to the International Labor Organization's report that 136 million health and social care workers are at risk of contracting COVID-19 in their workplaces. The ILO also noting that small and micro-sized enterprises have often found it hard to meet official safety requirements because many lack the resources to adapt to the threats posed by the pandemic.
This is the first time I can hear about this, cause of the rise of COVID contamination. I don't see how ILO can attribute the rise of COVID contamination to lack of safety protocols. We have 5,000 occupational safety inspectors, and they work every day. It's a daily inspection routine to see to it that the health protocols are strictly complied with in all workplaces in order to protect our workers.
Meanwhile, the Philippine government will mark Labor Day on May 1 by inoculating economic frontliners. 5,000 minimum wage employees and overseas Filipino workers will receive their first COVID-19 vaccine dose. They're part of the fourth priority group, which consists of transport workers, service workers, security guards, media, priests, and more. Now, more private companies also announcing plans to vaccinate their employees against COVID-19 for free. SM Investments is rolling out its inoculation program to thousands of its employees within the year once supplies available. The Philippines' biggest conglomerate says the move is key to operating safely amid the pandemic and building confidence in the country's consumer-led economy. SM also offering its facilities as vaccination venues nationwide for use by local governments. Meanwhile, Google will fund the vaccination of 250,000 people in several countries, including the Philippines. The tech giant says it's also committed to help build public trust in vaccines by raising up timely and trusted information in its search engine and on YouTube. As for ride-hailing app Grab, it has set up an initial $275 million fund to cover the inoculation of its drivers and delivery partners across Southeast Asia. Other companies that have announced their own free vaccination drives include the local units of BPO's Teleperformance in Accenture, as well as beverage giants Coca-Cola and Pepsi. More COVID-19 vaccines from China have arrived in the Philippines. Some 500,000 doses arrived this morning, bringing this month's Sinovac delivery to 1.5 million. The shots were purchased by the Philippine government. The latest delivery is raising the country's vaccine stock to over 4 million, more than 1.8 million doses of which have already been administered. On top of the Chinese vaccines, the government expects the delivery of Russia's Sputnik V vaccines in May and possible donations from the World Health Organization's COVAX facility.